Hi friends, how are you? Fine. So we have the next lesson, that is the best investment I ever made. What is investment? An act of putting money, time or effort for getting some profit. Example, you start a business with 1,000 rupees. You put 1,000 rupees and start a business. So your investment there is 1,000 rupees. You put some 5 lakhs and start a school. Your investment is 5 lakhs. Understand, that is money. You spend 2 years investigating something. That 2 years is your investment. Understand? You work from morning till night. That is, and you get something out of it. That is your investment. So your investment can be money, or investment can be time, or investment can be effort. So the best investment I ever made here means, that is the title here. That means, and whose investment? The others. Who is the other? Dr. Archibald Joseph Cronin. Dr. A.J. Cronin. He was a physician. He was from Scotland, so he is Scottish. A Scottish physician who invested or who put some money on a person. £7.10. That person, he was a young man. What happened to him? How Dr. Cronin invested? Why Dr. Cronin invested this much money on him, etc. We will see. And what is the profit that he got? Therefore he says, I got great profits. That's why he says, the best investment I ever made. Dr. Cronin was a physician. Halfway through his profession as a doctor, whatever, you know, he suffered from ulcer in his stomach. Ulcer. Then some kind of infection. And he was asked to take complete rest. He was working very hard. So now he stopped working and start taking rest. So he had to obey the advice of doctors. So during his period of rest time, period of rest, when he was resting, compulsory, the medical reasons, what happened is that he had in him, in his mind, or deep in his heart, he had the desire to become a novelist. And so he thought of writing. He started to write. His first novel, very popular, Hatter's Castle. And his best and most popular novel, The Cicada. Of course, he has written many novels and many stories, and most of these stories have been adapted by Hollywood people to make films. Stories for their films. So you can imagine how popular were his stories, how popular was he as a novelist. He was also a good physician and also an excellent, a well-known, a very popular novelist. So you are going to VR, myself and you, we are going to read that story, this story here, the best investment I ever made. Alright. You think of a November night. November, what is so peculiar about November? It's very cold, winter. Here also we can say, when you go, say for midnight services and so on. On Christmas Day. Now what happens, you can see, very cold, foggy. The atmosphere is foggy, smoke. You find it is smoke-like thing. Actually, this is not smoke. It is a mist, M-I-S-T, mist. That is very cold also. So think of a November night, 1 a.m. Just after midnight. Dr. Cronin was very young. He has just started his practice in a working class district, London. Why is it called working class district? Because that district, most of the people there, they were working class people. So it's working class. When you have a place where you have got only teachers, then you say it is teachers colony. Nearby my house, there is a teachers colony. It means most of the people there, they are teachers. So here, this is what happened, working class district was just started practice. We set up his practice. November, midnight, say just after midnight, 1 o'clock, somebody comes and bangs on his door. She banging like this. Dr. Cronin got up, put on his clothes and said, "What's the matter?" And there was a sergeant of police who came there. The police said, "See, nearby lodge, there is a case of suicide. Please come." So Dr. Cronin did not wait for answer or any other explanation. He put on whatever clothes he has, called first aid box, and then both of them walked as fast as they could towards the lodge. They climbed a staircase. It was very old one, so it was creaky. It produced a creaky sound, krrr, krrr, like this. It was very old. There was a landlady. She sat there in the attic. A-T-T-I-C, attic. Attic means a very small, narrow room on the roof of the house or a building. Very narrow. They made camp on the terrace also. Attic. Where you put all the useless things. It's a small room. There you put agri. So this boy, just a case of boy committing suicide, he had no money probably. He was a poor man. So he took that attic on rent because it is law. Can pay a meager sum. Very small amount he could take it on rent. So it's a case of suicide. They climbed the steps again as fast as they could. They found, when they entered the room, they found a boy almost dead. The illuminating gas is on, the gas cylinder is on. So he was breathing it. He wanted to commit suicide. He was attempting to commit suicide by breathing his gas. As soon as they reached there, of course they switched off the gas, and then they started the work of resuscitation means pressing your ribs, you know, to see whether a person can, or hitting on the chest and so on, to see whether a person can come back to life, start breathing. About 1 hour they worked. Both the doctor and this surgeon together, they worked on him, pressed him this side, that side. No hope. There's no hope. It's not breathing. It's not coming back to life. There's no sign of life. So they said, "Okay, we'll go." They were desperate. Suddenly there was a convulsive gasp. Then again they pulled. There is life in him. So they pressed him. After half an hour of hard work again, the boys got up and sat. "So what's the matter with him?" The doctor asked. The landlady also rushed to that place. "What happened to you? Why did you attempt to do such a thing, such a very bad thing?" Then he said his story. He said, "My parents died when I was very young. I was looked after by my uncle. He somehow managed to place me, get a job for me in a solicitor's office. Solicitor advocate. And then I was working there. I had nobody to help me, to guide me. So I fell into bad company. Started gambling, betting. Betting, playing cards. Cards not just for recreation, but for money. Bet on cards, bet on horses and so on. Horse race. He lost all his money, all his belongings, nothing more. So, as a last step, he stole 7 pounds and 10 shillings from the solicitor's office, because he was clerk there, and went for his last bet on horses. He lost. Then started thinking, my God, what, I have no money. What will I do? The solicitor will catch hold of me. I will be taken to the court. I will be prosecuted. So he had that a dream, nightmare, he said, nightmare. That is a dream that he is just imagining. Nothing happened, but he was thinking like this, oh my God, what will I will be taken. The policeman will beat me also. So he thought, I thought of ending my life. That's what I thought. So such a silly thing, you did this, sir. Anyhow, the three of them decided to help him out. The landlady said, for 1 month, I'll give you free boarding and lodging. I'll give you free food, no rent for your stay here. The surgeon said, I will not report this matter to the courts or the police. I will not report. I am supposed to do that. If I don't report, sometimes I may be at risk. Still, doesn't matter, I will not do that. I just will help you. Give you one more chance. The doctor said, I will give you 7 pounds and 10 shillings for you to keep the money back to the safe of the solicitor. That was the investment he made. What happens? He probably left all those bad company, became a good man. He grew up, got married. Now he is about 40 years old. Himself is a solicitor, and also he finds time to work. Work in a charitable institution, to do the works of charity. And what is the works of charity that he is doing? He is going around and finding young people, to find out whether they are in need of money, they are in need of help, they are in need of advice, they are in need of guidance. He is doing the work of redemption. Redemption means saving people from trouble. There is another meaning also. As you must have heard, Jesus redeemed us from the hands of the devil. That's another story. Here the works of redemption means going to different places where young men usually gather, like for gambling or for some kind of playing mischief and so on. And so what happened is that now he is a solicitor, but now at the same time he is trying to invest his time and effort and even money on young people who are in trouble or who need help. Thus, he was on his way, himself and his wife together, they were on their way to America, on board a ship. His name, John S. So the Johns, they are now going to America, on board a ship. It so happened the same ship, Dr. A.J. Cronin was also traveling. And this man, he recognized him and he wanted to talk to him. Dr. A.J. Cronin did not bother. He had no idea who this man was. He tried many times to reach Dr. A.J. Cronin when A.J. Cronin was alone on the deck walking. But he was shy. He was afraid, so to say. He couldn't go on. At last his wife pressed him. Go, go. And he's alone. So he went and took his card, visiting card, you know, these people carry visiting cards with them. Handed over the visiting card to Dr. Cronin. He read. And Mr. John asked Dr. Cronin, "Doctor, you don't remember me?" He said, "No, I have no idea." Then he told the November night, 1 o'clock, whatever. Suddenly, the whole thing came alive to his memory. Whose memory? Doctor's memory. Memory. November night, 1 o'clock, surgeon, attic, landlady, gas, illuminating gas, dead man, almost dead, they are working to bring him back to life, and all this. "Oh, you! I'm very glad to meet you. I'm very glad to see you like this." And then he said, Mr. John said, "We are not going on a pleasure trip to America. We are going around to find whether there are young people, adolescents, whether there are young people who need guidance, who need help, who need someone to listen to their problems, who need directions, and so on." So in other words, We are engaged in works of redemption, saving people. That's what happens in his life. Now he is a solicitor and now he is doing works of charity because once upon a time a person saved him. So he is grateful and thankful to him and thankful to God. Being thankful to God is not just thanking God, no. But what you should do is, you should act, you should do something. And that is what he is doing. So this is the story of the helping others. Understand? God said to Abraham, "You are blessed, so you should bless others. You are blessed, so you should bless others." That's what now this young lawyer is doing. This solicitor is doing. Once upon a time he was helped. Now he is going around helping other people. When he heard when A.J. Cronin came to know about the works of charity done by these people, he said, "This is the best investment I have ever made." So he put in some money on this young man. And what is the product? What is the profit? The profit, the product and the profit. Here is another man doing works of charity. Here is a good Samaritan just for £7.10. The capital investment is very small, but the outcome, the product, the profit that I got is very, very great. What we say in English, immense, I-M-M-E-N-S-E, immense, very great. So that's why he says, £7.10, my best investment I ever made, because the profit, the product, and that is, here is a man doing works of charity among young people, working for the young people, working among adolescents, youth, is going around doing that work of a good Samaritan. All because of my small investment of £7.09, and that's why he says, best investment I ever made in my life. Main points you can see. Point one, Mr. and Mrs. John S. met Dr. A.J. Cronin on board a ship going to America. I already told you about those things. Both husband and wife were working for the welfare of young boys and girls. That's adolescence, they said, youth. He was a solicitor by profession. Who? Mr. John. No. Once he was a, he was the clerk there in the office of a solicitor. He was a solicitor by profession. He also found time to act as the director of a charitable organization. Now he is the director of a charitable. Two in one. Three in one. Three means his husband, one, two, solicitor, and three, director of a charitable institution. And then he had great desire to talk to Dr. Cronin. He gave Dr. Cronin his visiting card, but Dr. Cronin could not recognize him. The moment he saw Dr. A.J. Cronin, he recognized him, but Dr. A.J. Cronin had forgotten everything. So he said, visiting card, still no idea. Don't you remember me? No. Then he gave a clue. November. So the whole thing came back alive. Then Mr. John has told Dr. Cronin about the way he saved his life. Doctor remembered that November incident at the attic of the landlady's lodgings. The surgeons of the sergeant of police and the investment of £7.10 that he made on Mr. John. That day he came to know everything. £7.10. Here is a man doing works of charity with his wife. That means the whole family. Yes. So what happened? Dr. Cronin considered it as his best investment ever made by him, because the boy whom he helped was doing works of charity. So he could produce a good Samaritan just for £7.10. Great. So we'll continue with this next class till then. Have a nice time. Take things easy.